Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on how to define prompts to select members in management reports for Oracle Enterprise Performance Reporting Cloud. Prompts enable report viewers to select the members for a grid row, column, or POV when they run the report. You define the member selections for the prompt when you design the report, and then report viewers can accept the default selection for the prompt or override the selection. The data for the selected members is retrieved from the data source and displayed in the report. In this report, you can see net revenue by territory for all segments in the first quarter. Although I can select the member for the segment's dimension in the POV, member selections for the entities and fiscal calendar dimensions are predefined and they cannot be changed at runtime. Let's add prompts to make the report output customizable. First, I'll define a prompt for the entities dimension displayed in rows. For a prompt, you define the prompt label that is presented to the users at runtime and the optional list of available members. If you don't specify a choice list, users can select any members for that dimension that they have access to. You can restrict users to a single selection or allow them to choose multiple dimension members. Optionally, you can select the member or members that are listed as the default for the prompt. I'll leave the default selection blank and save the prompt. Let's preview the grid. When prompted to select members of the entities dimension, I'll choose North America and Latin America. The grid returns net revenue for the selected territories only. Next, I'll define a prompt for the fiscal calendar dimension displayed in columns. I'll allow users to select a fiscal quarter to display data for the quarter and its months. I'll delete the current selection and choose the children function. I'll define the prompt as its member parameter. For the prompt, I'll define its label and the choice list. Notice that multiple selections are not allowed for the prompt because it is used as a parameter in the children member selection function. I'll confirm my selection for the grid columns and preview the grid. Notice that this time my previous selection for the rows is retained, and for the columns I can choose a single quarter only as defined in the prompt. The grid returns net revenue for the selected quarter and its months. You can inspect the prompt definition in the grid editor by selecting a column or row that contains the prompt and hovering over the formula bar. Lastly, I'll define a prompt for the segment's dimension in the POV for use with printable pages. In this case, I'll set the default selection. Notice that when you define a prompt for a POV dimension, the Print All Selections option is always selected by default and cannot be changed. Let's preview the grid again. This time, I'm prompted to make my selection for the report POV as well. I'll select desired segments and preview the grid output. If I click on segments in the POV, I can see my prompt selections for the dimension. Let's return to the report editor and preview the entire report. I'll keep my previous selections and run the report as a PDF. Notice that my POV selections for segments resulted in generating separate pages for each selection. It's a good practice to display the POV member selection on the page using a text function. In this tutorial, you saw how to define prompts in management reports for Enterprise Performance Reporting Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.